hear what you're saying, Cardinal, about the if you're having to fight someone to date them, it might not be worth it. But I would direct your attention to the ring. Take a look at who they're fighting and who they're potentially going to be dating.
Oh, no, I'm saying quite the opposite. I'm saying that maybe a Flagboy antagonist should settle down, look for someone nice, good personality, someone who might actually like the anemic and kind of like... I don't even know what to say about this. Not two of IPW's most desirable bachelors, certainly.
Shades of Big Brother Davey there with those little senton splashes there from Megan Kate.
Absolutely. And
now, the tricky position that you've got to put Flagboy in and antagonist in is you've got to fight these girls to date them, but you can't rough them up too much because who wants a date covered in bruises? I mean, they're for the beauty. You can't. You don't want to soil that beauty by injuring the girls.
No, Nate, do you look in the ring, right? You see the person in the red and the white with the Jufro. Do you think he's picking? Do you honestly?
Sorry, what? You lost me after looking in the ring.
Do you think he's picking? You know, most people would go up to a bar, meet a nice girl, have a discussion, and this is the least they have to go to get a date.
No, hold on. Now I'm going to stop you there, Cardinal. Flagboy and Antagonist, they're not short of ladies. Let's not make that mistake. These two can have anyone
serious?
They want. They just happen to want BFF, and BFF don't know how lucky they are to be courted by these two.
Oh, beautiful! Slap to the face from Megan Kate. And look, don't get me wrong, I have absolutely nothing against Antagonist and Flagboy as wrestlers, amazing talents. I followed their careers in depth. But they're not dateable.
Really? You obviously haven't been on the town with the triple threat. You haven't experienced the VIP treatment, the nightlife that comes with rolling with the likes of Flagboy Antagonist and Alfred Valentine.
Get a burger, get a schmuck and a pancake.
A bong and a waffle.
From the Swedish expatriate.
Cardano.
Oh my goodness! That farmer's carry mount kicks straight to the face and it's bra time!
This is it! We get to see it! We get to see Megan, Kate, and Evie's bras! They're gonna take their bras off, right?
No!
That was the stipulation. They go on a date or they take off their bras.
But look, let's get serious for a second here. These two women, two of the most amazing wrestlers in New Zealand, just went against two of the longest standing guys in IPW, beat them two on two in the middle of that ring.
Why is... But... See, I see a bra. But I don't see the right people wearing them. What's go...
And you know the problem now is that there's no way the antagonist is going to be able to get that off. He's never unclipped a bra catch in his life.
Now, come on. I'm sure he's helped his sisters a couple of times.
That's...
Hold on. I know that music, Cardinal. He's not. Jon Invincible's he's directing Flagboy back to the ring.
Invincible sending.
Now Invincible's been somewhat a bit of a loose unit over the last few months here in IPW. Last time these two saw each other in the ring, Flagboy ended up being powerbombed through a table. Then Justin Decent ended up being moonsaulted onto on the thumbtacks. And he's just hit the TBD. He's just hit the T-Boon drop.
A table?
He's not going, surely not again. He's not calling for another table with Flagboy. What is going through the mind of Jon Invincible? Every time we see him, he's got tables or thumbtacks or... This man's unhinged. I don't even know what's going on anymore. We all came to see some good, clean, healthy fun with Flagboy and Antagonist ending up in bras. Now there's tables being brought out and Jon Invincible had no part being involved in this match.
And Antagonist is in trouble.
Surely we're going to get security out here.
Flagboy, hoist it up. What's Invincible going to do?
No, he's not. Surely he's not going to go for this superplex off through the table. Woo! Okay, come on. Come on, Carno. This isn't fun anymore. We need to get security out here and get this man out of the building.
Oh, he's not done. Here come the BFF into the ring.
Now, what I want to know, Carno, are these properly fitted bras? Have they got the right strap and cup size for these two? Because if they haven't, that would just be embarrassing.
How can you buy a bra that would fit Flagboy?
And look, that black place obviously doesn't go with his red tights. This is just demeaning. This is embarrassing.